I'd like to send an email to my families and include an attachment with the email. For example, maybe I've saved my menus as a PDF and I want to attach the menus for next month to the email. As long as you're using Microsoft Outlook or an email program like Gmail that supports SMTP protocol, you can do that right through Procare. First, I'm going to select the families that I want to include on this email using the select filter icon. I'm going to choose all families who have a child in a classroom that is set to, well, I'm going to say toddlers, preschool, or maybe pre-K. I'll click exit, and now only those families are selected. To send the email, I'll go to Functions, Family Data, and choose Email Account. So now I'll type in a subject line. I might want to say something like ABC Kids, which is the name of my center, and then perhaps a menu for July. And then in the message itself, I may want to draw their attention to the fact that I have an attachment to this email. So I might want to say something like attached, please find the menu for next month. And then I can go ahead and click on the icon here with a paper clip. That's how I can attach a file to this email. So I'll click on that icon. And then I can browse to wherever I've stored that item. In my case, I've saved the PDF file on my desktop, and I'm going to browse to it. There it is. It's called July, menujuly.pdf. So now that's going to be attached. Notice in the lower right, if I was attaching something that was not a PDF file, maybe it's a Word document or some other format, I might need to select all files so that I can see other types of files besides just PDFs. I'm going to go ahead and click Open, which is going to attach it to the email. Now you can see the name of the attachment listed here, menu-july PDF. And then I just click Next. And on this screen, I can choose which people I really want to send it to. So these are only the families with children in one of those selected classrooms. I can mark the primary payers. If I want to, I can also include the secondary payers. Usually these are mom and dad. Anybody with a red line, that means either they don't have email or their address is invalid for some reason. And then if you want to, you can choose to record this in the customer log. It would just record the fact that you sent an email to them. And then you'd simply click send. And that's all there is to it.